solar system of solar panels to float in space. Longi Green Energy Technology Co., the world's biggest solar technology manufacturer, will send its solar panels into space. This is the first step in its plans to test the feasibility of harnessing the sun's power in orbit and transmitting it back to Earth with its orbiting solar system. The Xi'an-based clean energy giant, which has helped China dominate the solar industry by driving down costs, will also study the use of its products in harsher environments and assess their suitability for use in space programs. Longi's decision to establish a laboratory focused on the task could be a first step in the solar sector's collaboration with China's space program and toward off-planet power stations. With this, China is moving full steam ahead towards testing their space-bound solar technology designed to beam solar power from space to Earth. The prospect of harnessing solar power from space is attracting attention from industry and academics because it promises to remove the technology's major drawback, that panels don't operate effectively in darkness, by placing them into orbit with an unrestricted view of the sun. Chinese researchers said earlier this year that they had successfully tested a full system model of a technology designed to transmit solar power from outer space. Their project captures sunlight high above the ground, converts it into microwave beams, and transmits it through the air to a receiver station on the ground to be converted into electricity. It's a process advocates hope can be expanded to cover the long distances from orbiting panels back to Earth. Scientists at the California Institute of Technology also launched a space solar program after a $100 million grant in 2013, while teams in nations including Japan, Russia, and India are also studying the possibilities. Longi's new laboratory will also consider plans for energy monitoring satellite technology and environmental verification from space. In terms of solar power systems being used in space, the UK government is also considering a multi-billion-dollar proposal to build a solar power station in space. There are, however, some significant challenges to tackle. A space-based solar power station is based on a modular design, where a large number of solar modules are assembled by robots in orbit. Transporting all these elements into space is difficult, costly, and will take a toll on the environment. The weight of solar panels was identified as an early challenge, but this has been addressed through the development of ultralight solar cells. A solar panel comprises smaller solar cells. Space-based solar power is deemed to be technically feasible primarily because of advances in key technologies, including lightweight solar cells, wireless power transmission, and space robotics. Importantly, assembling even just one space-based solar power station will require many space shuttle launches. Although space-based solar power is designed to reduce carbon emissions in the long run, there are significant emissions associated with space launches, as well as costs. Space shuttles are not currently reusable, though companies like SpaceX are working on changing this. Being able to reuse launch systems would significantly reduce the overall cost of space-based solar power. If we manage to successfully build a space-based solar power station, its operation faces several practical challenges too. Solar panels could be damaged by space debris. Further, panels in space are not shielded by Earth's atmosphere. Being exposed to more intense solar radiation means they will degrade faster than those on Earth, which will reduce the power they are able to generate. The efficiency of wireless power transmission is another issue. Transmitting energy across large distances, in this case from a solar satellite in space to the ground, is difficult. Based on the current technology, only a small fraction of collected solar energy would reach the Earth. Despite all of these hurdles, pilot projects are already underway. The Space Solar Power Project in the U.S. is developing high-efficiency solar cells, as well as a conversion and transmission system optimized for use in space. The U.S. Naval Research Laboratory tested a solar module and power conversion system in space in 2020. Meanwhile, China has announced progress on their Bishan Space Solar Energy Station, with the aim to have a functioning system by 2035. In the U.K., a £17 billion space-based solar power development is deemed to be a viable concept, and the project is expected to start with small trials, leading to an operational solar power station in 2040. The solar power satellite would be 1.7 kilometers in diameter, weighing around 2,000 tons. The terrestrial antenna takes up a lot of space, roughly 6.7 kilometers by 13 kilometers. Given the use of land across the UK, it's more likely to be placed offshore. This satellite would deliver 2 gigawatts of power to the UK, and, while this is a substantial amount of power, It is a small contribution to the UK's generation capacity, which is around 76 gigawatts. With extremely high initial costs and slow return on investment, projects like these would need substantial governmental resources as well as investments from private companies. But as technology advances, the cost of space launch and manufacturing will steadily decrease. And the scale of the project will allow for mass manufacturing, which should drive the cost down somewhat. Whether space-based solar power can help us meet net zero in the coming decades remains to be seen. Japanese researchers develop solar cell backpacks to create controllable cyborg cockroaches. In the not-too-distant future, swarms of cyborg cockroaches could be the new first responders to reach earthquake survivors trapped under tons of rubble. At least, that is what a team of Japanese researchers say their most recent breakthrough could be used for. They have demonstrated the ability to mount backpacks of solar cells and electronics on the bugs and control their motion via remote control. A team of scientists at the Thin Film Device Laboratory at Japanese research giant Riken developed a flexible solar cell film 4 microns thick, about 1/25 the width of a human hair, which can fit on the insect's abdomen. The film allows the roach to move freely, while the solar cell generates enough power to process and send directional signals into sensory organs on the bug's hindquarters. The work builds upon previous insect control experiments at Nanyang Technological University in Singapore and could one day result in cyborg insects that can enter hazardous areas much more efficiently than robots. The batteries inside small robots run out quickly, so the time for exploration becomes shorter. A key benefit of a cyborg insect is that when it comes to an insect's movements, the insect is causing itself to move, so the electricity required is nowhere near as much. The research team chose Madagascar hissing cockroaches for the experiments because they are big enough to carry the equipment and do not have wings that can get in the way. Even when the backpack and film are glued to their backs, the bugs can traverse small obstacles or right themselves when flipped over. But the research still has a long way to go. In a recent demonstration, the researchers used a specialized computer and wireless Bluetooth signal to tell a cyborg roach to turn left, causing it to scramble in that general direction. But when given the right signal, the bug turned in circles. The next challenge is miniaturizing the components so the insects can move more easily and to allow for mounting of sensors and even cameras. They constructed the cyborg backpack with 5,000 yen, which is about $52 worth of parts purchased at Tokyo's famed Akihabara Electronics District. The backpack and film can be removed, allowing the roaches to go back to life in the lab's terrarium. The insects mature in 4 months and have been known to live up to 5 years in captivity. Beyond disaster rescue bugs, there are broad applications for the solar cell film, composed of microscopic layers of plastic, silver, and gold. The film could be built into clothing or skin patches for use in monitoring vital signs.